I'm going to show you how to fix a computer keyboard. I've been having problems with this keyboard, especially the letters Z, X, and C. When I press them, they just don't always register. I have to press them a little harder in order to get them to work. Unfortunately, there's not just one kind of keyboard when you get on the inside. But don't be afraid to take your keyboard apart. Go ahead, clean it. You look for debris, get rid of it. But I'm going to show you how to, like, take a keyboard apart and give you some generally ideas of like how to fix it. First thing I want to do is, well, it's unplugged from the computer, and so I'm gonna go ahead, flip it over, and on the back there are some screws. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove these screws. When you remove screws from a keyboard, be aware that what screws went in which locations, because it's possible that there might be more than one type or size of screw. So keep in mind where the different screws went. Okay, dump these screws out. And lucky for me, all the screws are the same type and size. Okay, and now there may be also like little snaps to take the keyboard apart. So I have all the screws out, and so it looks like there's actually like little snaps down here, like five of them. So what I can do this is pull this out. I have a little flat tip screwdriver here. Pull this out and kind of pry this up. Pull that out. And snap it open. There. Now this part with the keys on it, you can actually just go ahead, take this over to the sink and scrub this down. You go ahead and pop the individual keys out and clean those if you want. That's more of a pain. If you are gonna pop the keys out, take a photo of the keyboard so that you remember where all the individual keys went, so you can put it back together again. But yeah, there's like little bits of debris on the back here. You can blow it off. I've even read that you can put these in a dishwasher, though I've never tried that. I usually just kind of scrub them down with a scrub brush. Okay, then inside the keyboard here, let me see. So, the keys right here, so right down here is my Z, X, and C keys. So there's like a little rubber part on here. I can pull this off. If you spilled something on your keyboard, this will help protect the stuff from getting on the little circuitry stuff. But you can go ahead and take this and wash this off. You know, get any of the stuff off of that one. Then the actual working part of this type of keyboard is there's like a little plastic membrane here, or like two little plastic sheets, and they just kind of, I can kind of pull these apart here, and I can look for debris in here. And there was the problems with the keys I was having down here, so I'm not seeing anything in here. So I'm just going to go ahead and take like a soft cloth and just kind of wipe down around in there. I could probably also take like a little bit of a... Actually, there is like a little bit of a something there. Pick that off. A little bit of debris or something in there. I could probably take like a damp cloth or a cloth with a little bit of alcohol on there and wipe down in there. But I'm just going to go ahead and just take this cloth and just kind of wipe around down on here on both sides of this. And then hopefully that will help. If it doesn't, then I go ahead, take it apart, and try it again. Then to go ahead and put it back together. I mean, it's pretty obvious how this thing fits down in there. You got little guides for you. Like that. and then take this part. And then there's like a little part here where the cord goes out, so you can make sure the cord goes right in that. And keyboard goes like this, and there's a little notch there for the cord there. And so I'm just gonna go ahead and set that down. Snap that together there in the back. Snap together in the front. Now from here, I can go ahead and plug this in the computer, try it, see how it works. If it doesn't work, I can pull it, just snap it apart and clean it some more. If it does work, then at that point, just flip it over and start installing the screws again. And that's basically it. Don't be afraid to take your keyboard apart and clean the insides of it. At worst, you're not gonna fix it. It's gonna, you know, you maybe break the keyboard. You can go buy a new keyboard for 10 bucks or a little bit more. But go ahead, take a chance. Try to clean your own keyboard. Don't be afraid to get inside. Hope this helps.